Hey, my name is Radu. In this video, I'll show you how to import data from a website and put it right into Excel. More exactly, we're going to import this table from Wikipedia that shows us the population per country and put it into Excel using Excel 2016 web query. Okay, let's start. Maybe you're asking, Radu, why don't I just copy-paste the information from this table? And yes, you could do that, but you see here that the table is frequently updated. I mean, it updated today. So, what I want to do here is to have this information into my Excel file, but to have the latest update. So, this is why I'm using the web query feature. What I need from here, I have to copy-paste the URL, click copy, Control C, and then move into my blank Excel file. I'm gonna move into the data tab because here I have the options to get information from several sources. I can see here that I can get data from another workbook, text and so on, databases, even from Facebook. I'm still wondering what kind of information I can get from Facebook, and I can also get it from other sources like from the web. I'm gonna select this one from the web. And the interface is pretty straightforward. I just have to copy paste the URL. I'm still waiting for it to load. It loaded, so I'm gonna paste it here. Just paste the URL here. Click OK. It will now try to detect if I have some tables on that web page. Excel cannot import everything. It can import, let's say, table data. So I can click here to see what kind of information I have on my URL, and I see here that this is the table that I'm looking for, the table with the population for each country. So I can easily just click and load it, but I'm gonna click edit because I want to change some things into this workbook, into this table. So let's see what we have here. Excel now launches the query editor. So what I want to have here is the following. I want to delete the source. In my case, I don't need this column, so I can remove it very easily. I can click on remove columns and that's it. Then I would like to make the country name uppercase. Don't ask me why, just because. So I can make it uppercase if I move into the transform tab. And let's say I want to make it uppercase. I can see I have here several sections. I'm looking here at the text column and see if I can make it uppercase. It's pretty easy. So I can also transform the data while I import it. The population here, it's a problem for me because I'm not sure if you noticed it, but it's not a numeric format, but it's text. And the cause is this comma. Because we have multiple commas, it messes things up. So what I would like to do here is to somehow remove the comma, because that will transform it into a numeric value. So I'm going to replace the values and have something like this. Like if I see a comma, I'm going to replace it with nothing and click OK. Now I have a full numeric format, and I'll let Excel detect the data type here. Let's see if it works. Okay, and you see here that now we have numbers and not text. Usually in Excel, if we see something aligned to the right, it's a number, it's a percentage. If it's aligned to the left, it's probably a text. Here on the right, I can see every step that I took. Replace value, uppercase, and so on. You can see here. Another change that I want to do is to work on this percentage, because it doesn't look very right, right? So what I'm trying to do is to remove this step. What this step did was to detect the data type and turn it into percentage. But I still have a problem here with this dot, because Excel, especially my version of Excel, wants to have a comma here and not a dot. So I'm gonna change it. I'm gonna replace it again. I'm gonna move here so I don't mess things up. I'm gonna replace the dot with a comma. And click OK. Okay, and let's try now to detect the data type, so to see if things work out. And you can see now that I have a percentage with a numeric format, not a text, because before it was a text and it seems to show pretty good. So these are the changes that I wanted to make. Let's have also this one, detect data type, to make it a date. I made all the changes, now I'm happy with the result. I can see here the output, and then I'm gonna click on the home tab and just close and load. And to see the result here in my table, it should probably work, but it takes a little bit of time until it gets the info from the web page. And I see here the country is uppercase, the population is numeric. The date seems to be fine, and also this one, I'm not sure why it's not a percentage, but I can easily just make it a percentage here in Excel. If I want multiple decimals, it's pretty okay. So this is the Excel 2016 web query. This is how you import data from a web page. And if you want to refresh to update this information, I can click refresh or go into the query tools where I have multiple information here. There are lots of things to be said about this, but I wanted to give you a short example to see how you can import and also transform a little bit the data from a web page. This is it. If it was useful, hit the like button, follow me on YouTube for more tutorials like this, and see you in the next one.